the genes that control all the things we do, even control how we interact with the environment. And so my specific interest is in cell division, meiosis and mitosis. My real interest, though, is in meiosis, which is the way you make sperm and egg, which is a special cell division that takes your chromosomes, and normally everybody has two sets. You almost have a backup of everything. So you got two sets of chromosomes, and we only pass on one of them. And so this special division divides all your genes precisely in half and packages them into a sperm or an egg. The medical relevance of our work is that human infertility, particularly in females, fertility goes down as women get older, and women are reproducing it later and later, or older and older ages, and their fertility goes down with age. And the reason is because as women get older, meiosis starts to make more mistakes. The chromosomes, the genes are not divided in half, so you get an imbalance. And so our work is to understand how those mistakes happen. We choose to study this in a small little fruit fly. There's no moral dilemmas in working with them, so we can do whatever we want, and we can do it quickly, and so we get a lot of data quickly. And fortunately, meiosis happens, or meiosis uses a lot of the same instructions and proteins in almost every organism that sexually reproduces. So that means that what we learn in Drosophila meiosis will apply to human meiosis. And working with Drosophila, we work with it because we're interested in genetics, and that is an approach to biology. And what a geneticist will do is, first of all, identify all the genes and the proteins they make that contribute to a certain process. So, for example, we try to identify all of the, or most of the genes and proteins that control meiosis, make it happen. When I first started working here at Rutgers, we studied a particular gene called MyW68. It's a pretty boring name, because we didn't know what it was. We knew it was important for meiosis, and that's because flies that didn't have this gene were almost sterile. They just couldn't properly separate their chromosomes. And the reason was because they didn't have any of this genetic recombination, as we call it. That recombination process is ultimately responsible for separating all of the chromosomes and genes into halves. And there's a particular gene that's required, that the protein it makes is required for all of this recombination. And when I started work here, it wasn't really clear what that protein was. And so we working on this gene that we didn't really know what it was, because all we knew was the flies really needed it. You go into a molecular analysis and you find the DNA that is responsible for this gene, and it turned out that this gene was quite important. And that began a sort of a train of thought that this process of how recombination is initiated might be conserved in all organisms. And really, based on what we found in a couple of other model organisms, they then found the gene in mice and mammals. And that was quite an exciting time, because it was when people studying mammals, mostly mice, but of course humans, realized that really the basic mechanics of meiosis are going to be the same. Every now and then you find a fly that has a reproductive problem because they don't do meiosis very well. That gene is now very interesting to us. And we've spent most of my time here, as most geneticists do, doing what we call screens, trying to find genes which are important for meiosis through this almost random mutation assay approach. Mutate the gene, does it affect meiosis? If not, we throw it away. Rarely, if we find it, then we give it a cute name and we start to study it. Eventually, what you do is you build up a collection of all these genes that you've identified one at a time, and you put them together into some sort of a pathway of instructions for how meiosis works, or whatever process you're studying. One of the sort of wonderful things about meiosis is it's dynamic. You can see the chromosomes come together, you can see them come apart, you can see it when it goes wrong. You can learn a lot by just watching them do amazing things.